Hello, my name is Donna Spencer and I'm a website and application designer with a bit of a specialisation in information architecture and navigation design. Today we're going to take a deep dive into navigation, looking at vertical navigation bars for large screen. That might sound like a detailed topic and maybe one that you wouldn't need a whole video for, but I promise there's actually a lot more to it than you think. A vertical navigation bar is usually used at the left of the screen. It can also be used on the right, but you have to be really careful to make sure it looks like navigation, or it can be easy for people to miss. I've definitely seen both of them work just as well as each other. This kind of navigation is really good when you have a large number of top-level categories, where your terminology might need to be long or might need to be translated into a language that uses long words, and where your navigation might change, where you might need to add and remove things over time. The flexibility of a vertical bar is really handy, where it can be hard to do that on a horizontal. If your sitemap isn't really like this, for example, if you don't have many top-level categories, if they're fairly short, and if they don't change very much, look at horizontal navigation. But of course, vertical navigation works well for these characteristics too. Vertical navigation bars can be used for up to about three levels of hierarchy. The second and third levels can be shown as a flyout or an accordion. A flyout menu shows the second level of navigation next to the first. You need to make sure there's a clear visual connection to it, and when it's built, you need to make sure it's easy to move the pointer from the first level to the second level without it collapsing too quickly. To have a work on a touch screen, the first level has to be clickable, and you need to make sure there's a link included at the top so people can navigate to the top level page for that category. You can add an extra level of navigation to this as well, but three's enough, or otherwise you end up chasing it all around the screen. Another way to show the second level is with an accordion. Instead of displaying side by side, the second level is shown beneath the first. This is actually the kind of navigation I designed for most sites, as it's really flexible. You can include a third level in here as well, but again, no more than three, or it gets really hard to understand what level is what and what you're looking at. And as with the flyout, to make sure this works on a tablet where you need to click the navigation, you'll need to include an item for the first level page for that category. Otherwise, there's no way to get to it. For both flyouts and accordions, make sure you add an arrow icon to show which items have subpages. Otherwise, it's impossible for users to tell which items have more information and which ones they can click on and go to more for. You can combine both horizontal and vertical navigation. If you do, the horizontal navigation is always the top level or two, and vertical is always the levels of the hierarchy under that. You can't do it the other way. The visual hierarchy just doesn't work. People will always assume that the stuff towards the top is at a higher level than the stuff at the side. So this kind of navigation is good when you have a large number of top-level categories, where your terminology might be long or you might need to translate it into a language that uses long words, and where your navigation might change over time, where you need to add and remove things over time. The flexibility is really good. And remember that you can combine it with horizontal navigation to support a large website.